Last video, we collected 965 feet of stuff. That should be enough to get us to the moon, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
That poor woman.
Oh, we're just 2 feet short, man.
See, there's your problem. You were standing on top of a globe. You can't get good footholding on that.
You know, this is going to be like the Mars lander, right? They calculated in feet, but they programmed it in metric.
Well, that's the problem. The rabbits only played curveball. They think they know everything about engineering in space. So this is Central City. It's a completely useless hub world that is redundant in several ways. It is kind of neat for world building, at least. And we get to see just how much of a dystopian hellhole this city really is.
None of the fire hydrants are functional?
And they're very easily taken out by a single screaming rabbit. Someone should check on that.
Oh, there's gonna be one of those creepy Canadian safety commercials about this, isn't there?
You may have also noticed in the subtitles, there are several unfortunate racist stereotypes in this game. It's kind of something you have to live with if you're gonna play this game. Also, Santa Claus. For some reason, he spits out hamburgers when you attack him. I don't know why. Like, I figured out most of this game's humor, but this is something that I just don't get.
It was just a castle.
And after all that, he wasn't even the real Santa.
Please check your life insurance before accessing the site.
I had to give up my life insurance in order to pay for my third mortgage. So these portals into the various levels, it's supposed to be what takes you to the next area, but really it doesn't matter. There are several ways to get to the level select screen without having to go through the hub world.
3,200 feet.
Yeah, that's the minimum to access the next set of levels.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say, 3,200 feet seems awfully low for the moon.
Yeah, that's just to clear the first world. The objective overall is to get, I think it's 23,000 feet, is the minimum to see the ending.
Welcome to the People Company Enterprise Incorporated.
This is an interesting mechanic that isn't really used that much, unfortunately. The water jugs are very fun, and they have very generous lock-on. Even if sometimes it doesn't lock on to the right thing, at least you'll hit something. I was aiming for that cactus.
Oh. Throwing it with his little paws. That's a cheeseburger tree.
Yes. The cheeseburger Santa left it. That's how Santa works in this universe. Instead of leaving presents for good boys and girls under the tree, he hides hamburgers in bushes.
Oh my god.
Yeah, the first section of this level is pretty laid back, just introducing you to the concept of the water jugs.
Your effort is our success.
Very spot on, excellent satire. Would read again.
Sounds very corporate, yes.
That is a line that has several different variations and rewritten variants on it. They seem to be really proud of that joke.
Oh no.
What's your problem?
Oh, you don't want to know, lady. Just run away, go home, and pretend this was all a bad dream. Oh dear, yeah, there's no avoiding it. If you are any sort of ethnicity or something that is not a French white man, you will come under fire in one way or another with this game's jokes.
At last, something that the French are exempt from.
Oh, Some of the song choices are kind of questionable, but I do think that the use of Boney M's River of Babylon for all the elevators in this game was an inspired choice.
Sandra, report to my office immediately.
I'll be right there, sir. Can't pee first, I guess.
Hello, Sandra. Your time is...
I don't think this is what people meant by corporate gamification, but okay. These are little time trials where you can just go straight to the exit if you want, but you gotta pick up all that stuff.
I love the way the people climb up on shelves to get away from you.
Yeah, I like their art design too. It is very minimalist for reasons that we will see actually later in this video. They had to keep everything very low poly.
Please record your message.
I think that counts as some kind of performance art. Yeah, these gates that you pass by here, they also become an annoying puzzle later on. The parts without any music are very disorienting, because I'm so used to having full blast music all the time in some of the more intense sections of this game. You're married, come on. Then again, this is France.
Me go away.
I absolutely love the PA in these particular corporate office levels. Some of her dialogue is absolutely amazing. Oh yeah, I was setting up for a photo opportunity here. I think that's composed relatively decently. The problem, there's also the main problem with the photo mode, aside from the fact that you can't rotate the camera at all, is that the shortcuts are very unintuitive. I did eventually figure out that there are shortcuts for zooming in and out and panning the camera, but it's not very intuitive.
Your time in this zone is strictly limited. Remember.
So I've also, we've been talking about the music before. We'll go into a bit more depth later, but this song in particular that's playing right now, you might recognize it from some meme videos about Team Fortress 2.
I think I've seen those.
Yeah, I cut this one a little close. I wanted to get at least one of them with everything and collecting everything in that time trial, because they get really hard later on. You're not worthless. Your wife almost has kids. So this is my anti-copyright claim strategy, is just to scream over the music. Sometimes it works.
I'm actually kind of shocked this game has copyrighted music.
It has a lot of copyrighted music. Like we'll be seeing later on. I don't exactly know what kind of consistent theme they were trying to go for. Originally, I thought they were trying to have all the humans listen to like easy listening crap from the 60s and 70s, but there's some musical choices later that completely go against that. So I'm at a loss. Like, I don't think anyone is going to have like Jefferson Airplane, Janis Joplin, or Earth, Wind, and Fire as, you know, easy listening. Oh, and speaking of, here's Billy Paul.
Yeah, the selection is kind of all over the place.
I feel like if they leaned into more of the easy listening stuff, it would make for a better contrast from the absolutely crazy music that the Rabbids listen to. I was just hanging around to listen to this a bit. I mean, who doesn't like me and Mrs. Jones? So this is more typical of what the extra large sections are going to be like in this game. It's a big platforming challenge. There are a couple of sections later on in the game where they give you the extra large thing at the start and then make the whole level into a crazy platforming challenge. Additionally, there's that reoccurring graffiti of B-A-Z-H-R. I don't know what that means. I tried looking it up and it doesn't seem to make much sense. Are there any French viewers who could help me with that? Maybe?
Hopefully.
Maybe it's supposed to be like automatopoeia for their scream, like buzzer. Always gets me how dirty that toilet is.
These are the rabbits. I was not expecting a clean toilet.
And yes, I cut out another loading screen there. Every time you end or enter a new level, there's that going through the sewer loading screen. It was with reviewers, it was one of the big things they complained about.
So close.
So this is another menu, and it also allows us to customize each of our rabbits. From left to right, that's the main rabbit who's driving the cart, the one in front of the cart, and the one who's inside the Wii remote. So the gifts that we've collected, they allow us to customize our rabbit. That includes clothes, and also just changing their shape. So we got stuff like the spray can, where we could just change the color of certain parts of the rabbit's skin. There are also stamps. We could do like full body bucket sprays. And then we have the tattoos.
Oh my god.
Which we could just place directly on any part of the rabbit's body.
I like to imagine the rabbits do just have a rubber stamp for doing this.
Yeah. Well, there's two different types of stamps. These ones are just more generic shapes. And I spent a little time customizing my rabbit here. Behold, my masterpiece!
Beautiful!
And not only can you customize how your rabbit looks, you can also save that rabbit later on. There are also accessories. They're basically just hats. A lot of them we don't unlock until later in the game. Let's put a chicken on top of the rabbit.
This is amazing.
So tools allow us to change the shape and size and rotation of certain parts of the rabbit's bodies. This is what I think is the main reason why the game is so low poly, because I have to imagine that this kind of model customization is really resource intensive. So we basically just inflated his ears. And we can save our custom costumes as figurines. Basically just a way of saving it. But it's not just saving it. We could also change certain things like the mouth shape, the pose that they're in. This part doesn't actually affect anything. It's just for making your figurines look a little silly. There we go.
Oh my god.
We could also manage the figurines. I think you could store up to 100? No, it's 90, because there's a row in the back later on.
And now that's the rabbit that's going to be pushing the cart.
Yes.
Oh my god, this is great.
Yeah, this is also one of the ways to access like the level select screen without going into the hub. Is just to go to the inside the Wii remote menu option and then back out. I mean, there's loading screens in between, but it ends up being much faster than actually traversing the hub world. Also, the hub world's not that interesting.
Are we stealing a cancer patient? What are we?
You're not too far off, actually.
You are in a hospital zone. Silence and good hygiene are obligatory.
Oh, this is getting topical.
What could you possibly be talking about, I wonder?
He thinks he's Rabbids.
Yeah, there are two different types of dogs. The pit bulls are the ones that are not very friendly. So this is the other main function of the rabbit that lives inside your Wii remote, is to break things and lower switches and press things in the environment. Oh no, there's the neat bot.
Cough, wheeze, etc.
I like that.
Hello, sir. Nice to meet you. I'm Betty, and I'll be looking after you from now on.
Huh? Nurse Betty? I'm Barney. Our names both start with B. Now that bodes well.
Yeah, Barney and Betty are going to be recurring characters throughout this game. And this is an intercom. Every time you shoot down the intercom and pick it up, it will override whatever music is playing with some of the brass music that the rabbits really like. I guess I should probably actually talk about the music a bit, because it is a very specific genre. It is called truba, also known as Balkan brass. It is a type of folk music, primarily in Serbia, although there is some overlap. Please stop doing that.
Must be the cabbage.
I think it was trying. Yeah, I was trying to line up for a picture there. The weird thing is that I don't know why, but for some reason the mouth for screaming, if you zoom the camera in too close, it disappears.
Yeah.
Don't know what that's about. Anyway, the band that provided all the music, or the Rabbids music for this game, they're called Fanfare Vagabonds. They're based in Moldova, I think. They pretty much every song in this game is some sort of traditional Serbian or Romanian folk song, or rearrangement of such.
Interesting choice. Fits the Rabbids very well.
It most certainly does. And later on in this video, there will be a few particular standouts among the music.
I'm sorry. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
My Santa slippers! Like, oh my god!
The Santa slippers are a recurring thing. They're just like hospital slippers. But there are several jokes about the Santa slippers. Also, hi Santa. I said Santa slippers, not Santa slippers.
It was just a custom!
You lying bastard! How dare you insult children by pretending to be Santa Claus?
I think they missed an opportunity to still have the music for the elevator playing just muffled when you're standing on top of it.
It still does that, I'm just moving too quickly.
Oh!
Look at that sick throw! Really on point there!
Puppers!
Yeah, unfortunately, as friendly as those dogs are, they will still do damage on contact.
And if that's not the best summary of beagles I've ever heard.
Also, there's this weird advertisement in the background. We'll have to talk more about that later, but for some reason, this game has a lot of promotional tie-ins with Capri Sun. And that was one of the ads that they made specifically for this game.
Oh my god, now I gotta know if there were actual Capri Sun Rabbids commercials.
There were, but not for this game.
It's funny because these guys are almost more marketable than Rayman.
Yeah, the song playing there, that is one of the few times you can actually hear Fanfare Vagabonds playing one of their songs without the Rabbids interfering. There's a variation of that particular song that just has a Rabbid singing the lyrics instead. So unfortunately, I screwed up this jump, but I did eventually get this NPC to say the other variant of that I've almost got kids line, which I think is much funnier. Yeah, there we go. That's the line. Yeah, I think that variation of the joke is much funnier. Remember, somehow this got away with an E10 plus rating in North America. And Peggy 7 after it was re-rated from Peggy 3.
Did they actually release a copy of this with Peggy 3 on the box?
I don't know. I think they did, or it may have just been, you know, Peggy realizing that they made a huge mistake and having to get it submitted for reclassification. That's the other thing with the bots, they will only track messes. So if you hadn't run over that food there, the neat bot wouldn't have paid attention.
And then the door wouldn't have opened.
Also, let's kill a guy. Hope you had life insurance.
The jazziest elevators in gaming.
I mean, come on. Even I made a better elevator music filter during the Lords of Shadow 2 LP.
Yeah. You're not wrong.
Eventually. It took a few tries. But eventually I got it.
It's tricky to make a song sound tinny enough to be a crappy elevator speaker.
Maybe back in 2009, they knew about the future of YouTube copyright claims, and they wanted to punish anyone who played this game by having a claim for Rivers of Babylon by Boney M playing in the elevator every single time. And adding the elevator filter would screw with their plans. Yeah, obviously, if you go in the water there, it cleans up your shopping cart, so...
So you're no longer tracking crap all over the hospital.
Yes, exactly. Who knows? With this hospital, it may be actual crap that we're trailing. Also, this is what happens when you die. The Rabbids go crazy because they ran out of ideas, essentially. Oh look, there's Barney.
It's Barney the big item.
Yeah, there are gonna be a few new moves. Actually no, there are two movement upgrades. Technically there's only one. The second is kind of a fake movement upgrade where it basically allows you to traverse new areas. But there weren't any obstacles before that point. It'll make more sense. I do appreciate that this game is very creative when it comes to figuring out jumping puzzles without a jump button. Anyway, let's steal this patient. I hope you like novelty acts from the 70s. So when we have Barney with us, we do get a jump. actually. We get three of them by shaking the weird motor in the nunchuck. We will be meeting Barty several times throughout the game, so I won't talk about the song that's playing right now, but there is an interesting story behind it. And depending on where you're from, you might just recognize it. Yeah, as you said before, cough, wheeze, etc. is an excellent subtitle. The pinnacle of closed captioning. Yeah, as you can see here, the game resets your three jumps when you hit the ground. And because of the way that the friction and the physics work, it's very generous with what it constitutes to be the ground. Also, respect the pouch. Hashtag respect the pouch. this is pretty easy, but in later levels with Barney, oh my god, this gets stupidly hard, and that's before you try to get all the collectibles.
Okay, so you do slowly descend when you're Barney.
Yes. It gradually accelerates, but it starts out pretty slow. Also, I didn't even notice that the fat food advertisement there. It's weird to see like a GTA level satire ad right next to an actual ad for Capri Sun. From what I can tell, the deal with Capri Sun is that they had a sponsorship deal left over from an earlier Rabbids game, and so they just decided to make the most use of it with Rabbids Go Home. And this is not, and like I said, this is not the only instance of Capri Sun advertisements that we will be seeing.
What time is my operation again?
Well, whatever it is, it's been delayed by a lot. It's a good thing that he's trapped in that bubble there, because I don't think that the toilet he's about to go through is very sanitary.
Well, fellas, what's the chances he survives?
He's fine. Don't worry.
Oh, yeah.
He's completely fine. He's sweet, even. And, yeah, that's it for part two. We'll be seeing even more gameplay variety in the next part. There's a lot of stuff that goes on in this game, and it does start to repeat eventually, but it takes a while before we get there.
So we're still gonna see some pretty fresh humor for the next few episodes.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So good.